In the previous video, we only considered power functions with integer exponents. Now we will turn to the case of non-integer exponents. How to define power functions in that case? For negative x values, it is only possible in exceptional situations. So first, we restrict to positive values of x. We can use the rules of calculation to define the power function when a is a fraction. For example, what should x to the power 1 over 4 be? Well, according to the rules of calculation, we should have that x to the power 1 over 4 to the power 4 is equal to x to the power 1, which equals x. We define x to the power 1 over 4 to be the positive number which has x as fourth power. That is, x to the power 1 over 4 is the fourth root of x. In this way, we define x to the power 1 over n with n a positive integer as the nth root of x. Let us look at the graphs of these power functions. For even values of n, the graphs look quite similar. These functions are only defined for non-negative values of x. For odd values of n, the graphs look quite similar too, and are defined for all real values of x. These graphs are also point symmetric in the origin. Using the power functions that we have defined so far, and the rules of calculation, we can define more general power functions. For example, x to the power 2 over 3 is equal to x squared to the power 1 over 3, which is the same as the cube root of x squared. On the other hand, it's also equal to the square of the cube root of x. And x to the power minus 5 over 2 is equal to 1 over x to the power 5, to the power 1 half, which is 1 over the square root of x to the power 5. On the other hand, it is equal to 1 over the fifth power of the square root of x. In this way, we have defined x to the power p over q with p and q positive integers, as the qth root of x to the power p, or the qth root of x to the power p. And x to the power minus p over q as 1 over the qth root of x to the power p, or as 1 over the qth root of x to the power p. Not every number is a quotient though. For example, square root of 2 cannot be written as a fraction of two integers. How do you find power functions for such exponents? Well, this is a bit tricky, and we will return to this in the next week when dealing with exponential functions. However, I will show you the properties of power functions for general exponents. The first question is, for what x values are they defined? Well, in general, we have that if a is larger than or equal to 0, then the function is defined for x larger than or equal to 0. If a is negative, then we have to exclude x equal to 0. If a happens to be integer and non-negative, then x to the power a is defined for all x. If a is negative, then again we exclude x equal to 0. There are some non-integer exponents for which this holds as well. To be precise, if a equals p divided by q, where p and q are integers and q is odd. I'll be honest, you will probably rarely have to deal with such exponents for negative x. As for the graphs, if a is positive, they are increasing for positive x. If a is negative, the graph decreases for positive x. Furthermore, in that case, the graphs have asymptotes along the horizontal and vertical axis. If the power functions happen to be defined for negative x as well, the graph has symmetries. It's either line symmetric in the y-axis or point symmetric in the origin. Finally, let's have a look at the rules of calculation that we encountered before. As long as x and y are positive, these rules are true for any choice of a and b. But for other values of x and y, it depends. Problems may occur for negative or non-integer exponents. More about that in the exercises. That was a lot of information. To get a feeling for all the different properties of power functions, make sure you have a look at the exercises. Good luck!